let's go ahead and wrap up our discussion on measurements of location and position. And I want to talk about, actually show you very quickly here, how to find quartiles and percentiles using your TI-83 or 84. Let's take a look at the calculator. Okay, the data I'm going to use is the same data we used a little while ago when we did the histogram. That was some exam scores, 62, 73, 99, 93, and so forth. If you don't have it in your calculator, you may want to go back to that section and enter that data so you can follow with it. All right, now, what we said we want to do is find the let's do quartiles first. If I go to Stat, Calculate, and select one variable statistics, I need to tell it what data I want to look at. Well, I'm in L1. That's where I stored that data. So if I hit L1, tell it L1, which is just the second key followed by the one key, hit Enter, gives me a bunch of information. First of all, 81, there's X bar, that's the average. See N down here equals 20. That's the number of observations. And notice this down arrow right here. This down arrow says there's more. So if I press the down arrow key on my keypad, I'm going to go all the way to the bottom. And notice here it says min X. That's the minimum of X, which is 44. That's the smallest of the data values. And there's the quartiles. Q1, 72. MED is the median, 84.5. Q3, 92. Maximum is 99. Okay, that's it for the quartiles. Remember that made the five-number summary? Let's do a box plot real quick. If I go to Second and Stat Plot, which is the exact same thing I did back when I made the histogram, and notice all mine are off right now, which is good. I'm only going to use Stat Plot 1. I'm going to select Stat Plot 1, turn it on, go down to Type, and remember last time we chose histogram. Well, now I want a box plot. These two box plot icons do something slightly different. What happens is we have an outlier, and your textbook actually defines the definition of an outlier. If you have values that fall under an outlier, this icon will put little dots out to represent the outlier. If you choose this icon, it will not identify the outliers. It will just make the whisker part of it go all the way out to the end. So for this part, I'm going to go ahead and use this icon. It doesn't really matter. Again, my data is L1. Frequency should be 1. So if I do a zoom 9, there's my box plot. That's the box plot for the data. Matter of fact, we drew that by hand earlier based on the five-number summary. If I do trace, it immediately jumps to the median, which is 84.5. If I move the left arrow key, there's the first quartile, 72. There's the minimum, 44. Go back to the right, there's Q3. At 92, and one more to the right, there's the maximum. Okay, so there's a box plot very quickly in your calculator, along with doing quartiles. Now, percentiles. Percentiles, there's no easy way to calculate to do the percentiles. The only thing I can use the calculator for is to help sort the data and to identify the values once I know the location. If I do stat, and see option 2 says sort A, the A stands for ascending. That means smallest value to biggest. So if I select sort A, and I tell it I need L1, hit enter, it says done. If I go to my editor now, which is right there, see, it's the 44 is the first value, then 62, 65, 70, it sorted the data for me. Now notice here on the bottom it says L1, parenthesis 1, parenthesis equals 44. It's saying the first value in L1 is 44. Let's go down a little bit. How about the 84? The 84 is my 10th value. L1, 10 is 84. Okay, now let's go back and calculate the percentiles. I need the 85th percentile, so 0.85 times 20 is 17. That's my location. Now remember, we needed to take the 17th and 18th value and average them. Well, I can tell the calculator L1, 17, it says, oh, that's 94. I can also tell calculator L1, 18, it says, oh, that's 96. Now, if there weren't values you couldn't figure out in your head, you could always just say, all right, 94 plus 96 divided by 2 equals 95. So that's what I would report as the 85th percentile. Now, if you're kind of sort of slick with your calculator, you could do this. I could do parenthesis, L1, 17, parenthesis, plus L1, 18, parenthesis, parenthesis. See these two parentheses, one on the outside on the left and the outside on the right. It says keep these together, divide it by 2. So let's go say go find the 17th value in L1, the 18th value in L1, add them together, order of operations, basic arithmetic, then divide by 2, and there's my 95. So I could avoid having to write down those values and doing it by hand. Okay, now, what happened when we added another value for it to it? We went, all right, I need the 85th percentile time. This time there's 21 values. Remember I added 100, and somebody got 100, perfect score. 17.5 is my location. Whenever I end up with a decimal value, I'm always going to go up to the next value, which is 18. So I could just tell my calculator, L1, 18, enter, and there's 96. So the 85th percentile, if I had 21 values for this particular data, would have been 96. Okay, that's all that we can really do with a calculator. In the next section, we're going to take a look at measurements of dispersion, which is how data is spread out. Now that we've concluded measurements of location position, where data is in a number line, just talk about how data is spread out. See you in the next section.